Hey, what's going on? How y'all feeling today, Mr. Justice Camera? All right. So, of course, before we begin, if you can hit that subscribe button, tilt it a little more. If you can hit that subscribe button, it'd be greatly appreciated. Like, comment, and if you want to, you can share and, like, you know, let other people know the perspective. So today I wanted to discuss something that actually slid across my desk. There was a news anchor on a news channel. Can't remember which one it was. So I didn't actually see it live, but I ended up hearing about it later on. But the lady's name was Alex Housedon. She was like one of the reporters, basically blonde hair, white reporter. And then there's not Alex. There's a guy named Jason Hackett. I think that's what his name was. He was the other news reporter. So they're both on the news and they're reporting about some type of animal, gorilla or something like that in the zoo. So she's, the camera goes to the fucking gorilla, and the gorilla's all up in the camera looking crazy. So she says, oh, look at him. Look, he looks crazy. Yeah, like, he looks kind of like you. So, like, what the fuck? So she literally said this shit to a black man that was working with her on the news. And like, yo, this shit basically got a lot of attention. People are all talking about it. She should be fired, this and that, this and that. And people are upset and outraged. People are like, it ain't trying to hear that shit, you know? She basically crossed the line with the racism. She said the fucking gorilla looked like the man. And if that wasn't fucking racist and disrespectful, I don't know what the fuck is. It was clear. Like, yo, what, that shit wasn't even fucking debatable, bro. Like, what are you doing? So this bitch decides to go ahead and say that dumb shit. So the next day, they let her go on air with the dude, and she automatically goes into fucking victim mode, like most of these white supremacist bitches do. And she starts breaking down, crying, and oh, I'm so sorry, blah, 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 blah. And listen, so anyway, so she goes down and tells the dude, you know, I didn't mean to offend you or whatever like that, and I'm sorry, I'm not that kind of person. I have black friends. You've been a friend of mine for a long time, such and such. I love you, blah, blah, blah. And then she puts her hand on his arm and shit. Whole time, the dude's just sitting there with this stupid-ass look on his face. So after that, she talks for about maybe 15 seconds, 10 seconds, and then the dude starts talking. He's like, well, I accept your apology and this and that, and there's all this other stupid-ass fucking shit. And then he says, you know, I think this is a teachable moment, and I think we should put this behind us. And I know you didn't mean it like that. It did hurt my feelings, but I do accept your apology. And he puts his fucking hand on her leg. Then he goes on this fucking 2-minute, 30-minute tangent, like, just talking and explaining why the fucking shit was, like, acceptable or why it should be overlooked. I'm like, bro, what are you doing, bro? First off, why the fuck are you putting your hand on a female's leg in 2019. That is a goddamn mistake. Bro, are you retarded? Do you know what the fuck is happening to dudes who do shit like that? Let alone on the air. Bro, you did that shit on the fucking air. Like, yo, you might have just doomed yourself to jail in like, what, another 6 years. Fuck it, that shit could be 20 years down the road. The shit is already on the internet, bro. And there's video evidence of you sexually harassing a woman, so she decides to take it that way. But, you know, that automatically was completely stupid. So then this motherfucker goes on a goddamn long-ass tirade talking about how her apology was acceptable and how we need to come together with love and all this other dumb shit. Like, dude, why the fuck are you talking right now at all? Like, you literally should have had, like, one or two words to say to this bitch, and that should have been it. And then you should have just let her completely keep digging herself deeper in the fucking grave, because that's what was happening. I mean, she started off making all these stupid-ass excuses most white supremacists use when they say racist shit. And then you pulled her out of the goddamn water by making a whole long-ass tirade for her. Like, what the fuck was the point of her even saying anything then if you're just gonna basically go that direction? And then here's the fucked up part. You had a bunch of people calling and texting the radio station on Twitter and shit and basically saying they want her fired, but then you came out and apologized. And the radio station basically said, well, the decision is up to them. Whatever they decide to do, that's on them. So basically you said, all right, well, look, she can keep her job for saying some racist shit, bet. You know, y'all need to chill out. I don't want her to get fired, blah, 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 this and all that other stupid shit. Basically, you validated the whole entire thing because you were being a fucking tap dancing goofball. So pretty much what happened with that situation, man. I mean, this dude, like I said, I looked at the African diaspora on YouTube, and I agree with the dude, man. Dude basically said, hey, If I'm not offended, if he's not offended, I'm not offended for him. We don't need to waste our energy fighting for stupid ass motherfuckers like this, who are basically gonna just undermine the movement anyway, and just go against everything we're fucking fighting for. Like, what the fuck is the point of that, man? So, the end of the day, fuck that. Fuck him. I'm not gonna go on a long ass tirade about that shit to the news station, because at the end of the day, if he's comfortable with getting called a monkey or a gorilla, hey, that's on him. I'm not gonna fight for no motherfucker that won't fight for himself. So, to hell with all that shit. What do you guys think about that shit? You can look it up on YouTube if you haven't seen it. it's Alex Housedon and I think Jason Hackett is his name. They're two news reporters that did the news. And she basically called this man a goddamn gorilla. So, how you guys feel about it, man? You think he was in the right or wrong the way he went about expressing himself? And do you accept her bullshit apology? I don't want to sway you. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Meanwhile, I'm going to go ahead and skip. Take it easy. Peace.